Yo, what's up, guys? How you doing? Okay. Oh, the hearts. Okay, thanks, guys. Appreciate it. All right, yo, listen. I don't need. Well, you guys don't got to do that. Listen, let me tell you something. I'm gonna be real with y'all. First, I don't know if any of you saw Sam's stream, but that's other stuff. But I'm gonna be real with y'all for a second. I'm probably giving up on this 30-day challenge. I don't feel it anymore. I just don't feel it, dude. I have to stop the 30-day challenge. I mean, I can't, like, I'm literally going live at 8:59. Like, that's bad. Like, I'm literally pushing, like, procrastinating and pushing myself to not stream, and it's, like, not good. And I'd rather just take the fucking L and just not finish it, give the fucking money to a viewer, and just stop it. Like, honestly, I'm just pushing myself to an unnecessary point. It's just, like, not good. Like, I don't like streaming 30 days in a row. This is awful.
I just wiped my ass for 15 minutes.
Amazing, dude. That's awesome. I mean, we've been live for 15 days in a row right now, and it's really, I just don't like it. I do not like it at all. I need to stop this. So yeah, that's probably what I'm gonna do here. I'm just not one of those streamers that can do it for 30 days in a row. I just can't. But it was a challenge. I tried, but I just can't, dude. You know, I'll give a fucking viewer the last 3 days of revenue. And like, I'll like do like a dice roll or something in the chat, and somebody will get like $3,000 or whatever fucking amount it is, and then I'll just fucking just go back to normal fucking streams, not 30-day challenge. I am going to have to take the loss on this, and I can see it myself. My streams are very much getting affected by this, and so am I personally. So I'm going to have to take the loss on this one. I know it may not seem like, streaming is a hard job and this and that, but it's not even about that. It's more about myself and, like, stuff that I'm just feeling in my own head than anything else. And it's really just getting to me. When streaming starts to feel like it's a hassle, that's not good. And the past few days, it's been feeling like a fucking hassle. And I'm sorry, but I'm gonna just have to stop the 30-day challenge. It's just not good for the streams, and it's not good for me. It sucks. Like, I really want it to be like, one of these motherfucking streamers that can go for like 30 days, 2 months in a row, just everyday streaming, but I just can't. It's just not me. I just can't do that. Thank you, Wise. Appreciate that, homie.
It's okay, but we need to know about what is important. Where's the content, King Ernest the Chicken?
The chicken's in the backyard. He's just, oh, let me show you something. The chicken laid an egg. Look at that. This is the weirdest fucking egg I've ever seen in my life. Look at that. It's like, what is that? Like, it's not cracked or anything, but it's just like, that's just how the egg came out, and it's brown.
Paul, don't give up. Don't be quitter. You only have 15 days. You have progressed a lot. You don't want to be called quitter, quitter.
Yeah, but it's not, like, I just rather not, though.
It's not the 30-day stream, it's you need help, remove yourself from the Reddit, stop in users due to your feeling, that's the root of it all, let the mods manage the Reddit and you manage your health.
Look at this, and we open the egg, let's see what's in it.
Take a test.
Dude, those online psychology tests are all bullshit. What is that thing? What is it, dude? What is that? Is it a fucking dead chicken?
Take a break, ice.
What is that, dude?
Imagine not being able to turn on the camera for 3 hours a day and literally print money. Pathetic.
I mean, I can turn on the camera and literally print money, but, you know, it's more than just that, bro.
The fact that you tried is good enough, homie. You're the shiznit, you dirty goblin.
I'd rather not turn on the stream and just print money, dude. I'd rather turn on the stream and, like, want to do it. Yeah, I put the egg in the freezer.
Sorry, got no sympathy for you. You're lazy, undisciplined, and surround yourself with useless people like Vold and SSJ. There are hard-working people who are literally disgusted by your attitude right now.
Alright, well, everyone's different, man.
I started watching you last year, and this month has been really fucking entertaining. You being pushed in a corner has brought some really great experimental streams. You are known for not giving up. Don't.
How about that one, dude? I think I give up on half the stuff I do.
Take care of yourself, Paul. You're my favorite autistic purple heart.
Thanks, bro. Appreciate that, man. Let me wash my hands. Dude, it's not an embryo or anything. It's just like, because there's no rooster, there's no semen.
People who care about you will hate you for quitting. People who do care will see that it's not good for your mental health.
I realized that one. Hold on, let me...
Don't quit. You need to talk with Mr. David Goggins.
I don't know who the hell that is. But okay. I'll talk to about it in a sec. Yeah, no, there's no... That wasn't an embryo, because the fucking chicken was not being, like, there was no semen, there's no rooster that fertilized the chicken, so that, you know, that makes sense. Alright, yo, let me tell you something, guys. I really thought hard about it last night, and I was like, alright, am I really going to continue this? I got some opinions from everyone around me, and literally nobody thinks that I should continue the challenge because of the way I, you know, express my feelings towards...
Paw, stop writing checks your ass cannot cash. We deserve better than this. It's 30 goddamn days. Pull your panties up and get it done. Time to change your life or no balls. CS. That normie from BuzzFeed did a week straight and you can't handle 3 hours a day messing around and live? I work 8 hours a day doing real work. Real labor. Everyone else in the world works 8 hours.
I mean...
Today I don't feel like doing
okay, I mean, everyone's different, bro.
How do I win the chargeback from my stream? It was $500 and it was unauthorized. What do I tell PayPal?
Just say that it was a donation. I mean, that's what I say, basically.
Mr. G is going insane.
Mr. G has always been insane, so that makes sense. Okay, let me explain how I feel.
Hey Ice, you need time to recharge and be fully mentally charged for your top tier streams. I get it. A lot of people get it. Ignore losers who are selfish and don't care about your mental state. CS. You are inventing problems in your head because you are getting too comfortable. Would Broke Ice even question streaming daily for 3 hours?
Broke Ice streamed... Yeah, 3 to 4 hours, literally 4 days a week, dude. But, you know, you don't know because you haven't been watching for 3 years like some people have. You should see how long I actually streamed when I started streaming, dude. It wasn't longer than 4 hours a day, ever. And it was literally 4 times a week. I literally streamed 2 days off. Streamed 2 days off. That's what I did. All right, so let me pause the donations for a second. So, this has nothing to do with streaming, by the way, or the difficulty of streaming, or anything like that. I'm not saying streaming's a hard job, or this and that, everyone's different, blah, blah, blah. This goes deeper than that. This goes deeper. This goes, you know, something that's within my mind. Theoretically, yes, I can turn on the streams and bullshit, you know, a couple hours a day for 30 days. But that's not what I want to do. And at the end of the day, I think... what's most important is what I think is best for the stream. And if I'm actually not wanting to turn the stream on and I'm waiting till 8:59 to turn the stream on, that's bad. That's not good. I haven't been on time. I haven't streamed on 4 o'clock at all this week because I'm having that resentment towards streaming right now because I've just been doing it every day for 15 days. And it doesn't seem like a lot, but I mean, to me, it is. To me, it is. You know what I mean? To everyone else, sure, maybe it's not, but to me, it is. And I don't like that resentment feeling, and it's making me question a lot of stuff around me, and I don't like that. It's making me question a lot of just everything that goes on around me, and it's in like a negative way, and I'm having like negative thoughts, and it's just not good. I need to, you know, have time for myself. And I know you may say, oh, 21 hours a day isn't enough for yourself, but I need a whole day to myself where I'm not thinking like, okay, I need to go live fucking later today. You know what I mean? I need to just, like, I've been sleeping as well longer and longer as the month's been progressing. I was on a great sleeping schedule. I'm still only drinking water, but I'm like waking up at like, I woke up today at like 5 o'clock in the afternoon, dude. Like, that's not good. Like, I need to, like, if I complete this 30-day challenge, the thing that worries me is that I will be so far gone in like a very bad state, it's gonna be hard to get out of that. Whereas I'd rather just end the fucking challenge, not be in a fucking terrible state, and to just get right back to it. You know what I mean? This reminds me a year and a half ago when I went to Europe. I was traveling in Europe for a month, and I wanted to go back to LA. I wanted to go back home. You know, 3 weeks in, but I pushed myself another week, and it was like 4 weeks in, and finally I was just like, I gotta go back home, guys. Nobody wanted me to go back home. Everyone was like, go travel, you know, across Europe, keep traveling, fuck LA, don't go back to LA, and all this stuff. And I was like, you know, that's not good. Like, I was like, fuck, I need to just go back to LA, I'm sorry. And I stopped traveling, and I went back to LA the next day. And I took, you know, some time off. Took a couple days off or whatever. And, but then when I came back, I was doing, like, we had really good fucking streams. Whereas when I was in Europe, streams weren't that great towards the end of the month. Because I was just not feeling it. And, you know, basically the moral of the story I'm trying to say here is that I shouldn't force something if I'm not feeling it. And if I'm not feeling this 30-day challenge, I shouldn't force it. Because it's really going to affect the streams negatively, and it's going to affect me negatively as well. Because there's not many jobs out there that are truly affected based on your mental health. There are a lot of jobs, actually, that are affected by your mental health. But, you know, a lot of the jobs you can autopilot, you know what I mean? I was a line cook. Worked 8, 12 hours a day sometimes. That was all an autopilot job. I could have felt like shit. I still went in, autopiloted, fucking did my 8 hours, left. Easy. But with streaming, if I'm not feeling it, if I'm not in the right mindset, it makes it hard. It makes it hard to stream. It makes it hard to want to go out, want to sit here, want to, you know, speak and be creative. Because my creative mind is stunted when I am not in the right mindset. It is very much stunted. And, you know, there's not many jobs out there that I've worked in, at least. I'm speaking solely on my experience. I've never been a doctor. I've never been a police officer. I've never been a welder. I've never done any of these other stuff. I'm solely speaking on my own experiences because I really only know how to, you know, compare things to my own experiences. And to on my own experience, I've worked a couple of other jobs, and none of them I've needed to have creativity with. So it was very much easier to do those jobs, even when I felt bad. But with streaming, if my mental health is really just not in the good mindset, and it's like I need to just take a break and just like grab myself for a couple days, like I should do that. And when I say, like, I'm not taking a week off or anything like that. That's not what I'm saying. But I'm saying I'm just not wanting to do the 30-day challenge anymore. I don't want to go live every day for the rest of the month anymore. Because it's just affecting me personally. And some people may think I'm a baby or a bitch or something, but you know, we're all different. Everyone is a different, everyone in this world is a different human being. And human beings, you know, that's what makes them great, because we're all different and diverse. And that's what makes the world interesting. If we were all the same, it would be boring. So, you know, it's something that hopefully everybody can understand. And I just can't do the 30-day challenge anymore. I don't want to. I can't.
Lilies, you got me fucked up talking about he deleted Eternal at Take Two.
All right, no media right now, but thank you, dude. And this isn't like a sympathy thing or anything like that.
Imagine being a viewer and being triggered. BC, he needs a day off and help. Half of you fucks probably don't even have a job. Paul, keep up the good work.
Thank you, dude. And let me say something. We have streamed 15 days
in
a row.
Streaming takes up a lot of energy. People in the chat, Reddit, and real life throw off that energy. Most people don't understand how stressful this can be.
Thank you, dude. I mean, that you have a point there. But, what was I going to say? Fuck, I was just going to say something. I totally forgot. I was going to say something, but I don't remember anymore now.
Paul, your viewers are toxic. They abuse you and are not enjoying your streaming. Stop feeling pressure from the incel Reddit to be on time and to stream every day. Take 2-3 days off regularly. You need to. I changed my mind, Ice. Put your big boy pants on.
Thank you. Fuck, I was going to say something. Okay, yeah, there's something to do with, like, sympathy, blah, blah, blah. I already went through that. I'm not sad. Some people thought I was sad, or, like, depressed or something. I'm not sad or depressed. And honestly, whatever issues I have going on in my head has nothing to do with why I'm stopping a 30-day challenge. I mean, maybe a little bit, but it's mainly just, I don't like the pressure, I don't like the resentment, I don't like the feeling of having to hit these, like, timelines or, like, deadline or something. Like, I don't know. I just want to be able to wake up and just be like, okay, let's have fun today. Let's go live or whatever. Instead of wake up and be like, all right, I'm working a job right now and I have to fill in the 30 days. Because that's the thing. With streaming and entertainment, it shouldn't feel like a job. Some of you may not understand why that is the case, but if something feels like a job, you start to hate it more. You start to, you know, not like it as much. And I really don't want streaming to feel like a job. I really want to have fun when I go live. And going live every day for 30 days and having like all this, because in my mind I'm just thinking, I can't get it out of my mind that there's 15 more days. I can't get that out of my mind, and it's just affecting me in a way that makes me not have fun, which is not good for me or the stream. And you know, streaming is my job, but it doesn't need to feel like a job. If you know what I'm saying.
You need to wake the fuck up. You have a good life. An easier life than most of us. You're on your phone 24/7. Update your fucking fans. Care about us. You're ruining yourself. Relax. Stream. Grow.
I care a lot about my fans. I care a lot about what you guys have to say. And I was talking about this on Sam's stream earlier. As much as I hate to admit it, because I hate this about me, validation is very, very important to me. So I probably care way too much about what people in my community and what the viewers think. I care way too much about what people say, but I can't help it because I need validation, because I'm very confused about, I don't know, just like how I should feel sometimes. And sometimes, you know, I need validation on like, okay, what I just did, was that good? Was that bad? Like, sometimes I just don't understand stuff. And you know, I do care a lot about what people have to say regarding my streams in this community and regarding me as well. To the point where, you know, I want to push myself. And we've streamed 15 days in a row. 15. I have never streamed 15 days in a row, to my knowledge. I'm pretty sure I've never streamed 15 days in a row. And that's a fuckload. That's a lot. Like, I really, that's crazy. Like, usually we stream, I think maybe, like, the most I've ever streamed in a row was, like, maybe 6 days. 15's a lot. And I think we've done a good job, but I just can't continue anymore without it negatively affecting my streams and myself. And honestly, I'm not really worried about it affecting me negatively, okay? I've done a lot of stuff that affects me negatively. I don't really care about that. I'm willing to sacrifice a lot of myself for everything else around me. Because, you know, it goes back to the validation thing. If I sacrifice a lot of myself to things around me, then I get good validation. And that's what I thrive off of, because I don't really understand the world that, you know, that well. So, but I understand myself a lot. And I don't really know how to explain that any differently, but, yeah, I don't know. I just lost my train of thought, but I just hope you guys know what I'm saying.
I'm sure if Old Eddie was to do a 1 month challenge, he would have completed it.
No. Yeah, I don't know what I was gonna say.
Look, you've created a community that lives vicariously through you. They literally have no life. When you don't stream, they have more time to hate themselves. Ignore the hate that is coming your way. It's one challenge. Y'all need to chill TF out.
So I talked about this on Sam's stream earlier. And I've always denied this because I don't like admitting faults to the World Wide Web. Because, you know, there's a lot of bad people out there that shouldn't know what my faults are. But, you know, but Sam and I had this conversation, and, you know, when I was younger, I was diagnosed with Asperger's. And I'm not very socially awkward anymore. I used to be, but I'm not anymore. But I still have a very difficult time understanding stuff. And that's also, you know, what I mean by the validation really helps me understand shit. You know, if something is negatively affecting me, I don't know. Like I said, I'm willing to sacrifice a lot of myself for the validation, but I just don't want it to affect the channel and the streams negatively, because, you know, there's a lot of people that really enjoy the streams, and I don't want them to have to suffer through, like, low effort shit because I'm just not feeling it anymore.
Wah, streaming is hard. Wah, baby, rage, wah.
Thank you, dude.
We understand, homie. Your mental health is more important. I hate my job and life. Watching you gives me a break from real life. Thanks for the content. Take care of the simple things. We love you. Ice. Please explain how grief can take 3 months off streaming at a time and come back and have 25k viewers playing Minecraft. Does this affect your motivation? Seems like the bulk of fans have left.
No. Greek is streaming on Twitch, which is a very niche community. And he's within the community all the time, going on other people's streams when he's not streaming. And he's, like, you know, staying relevant in other ways. So it makes sense that when he goes live, he has 20k viewers. That has nothing to do with my motivation, because I understand why that is. If I didn't understand why he had 20k viewers, then it would affect my motivation. But since I understand why it is, then it doesn't affect me at all, because I get it.
If you had a TV series, you would be expected to produce a series for the audience. This is a weak move, TBH.
I mean, you're right, but... It's,
YouTube is easy money, just make vids and dab haters smile. Hi, my name is Paul, and for the next 30 days I will be streaming every day.
Hey, 15 days. I made it halfway. More than I thought I would, honestly.
I feel you, bro, but also we're not doing this just for fun anymore. You're also running a business and are beholden to those that pay this case our viewers. Learning to operate under pressure is good for you. You need to take it one step further. Take a break until you move into the new house.
Risk and reward,
then start a new chapter with one or two well-planned out and well-produced streams per week with highlight bits.
So there's risk and reward behind what you just said to the guy who said, you know, running a business, work under pressure. What is the reward of me finishing the 30-day challenge versus what is the reward of me getting, you know, just saying I'm done with the challenge and, you know what I mean, just continuing as normal? To me, I'm looking at it, the me completing the 30 days has no reward at all. Whereas if I stop the 30-day challenge, then I just won't be burnt out. I won't feel the resentment, and I can just, you know, continue with my, you know, my daily happy living. Some people in the chat say viewers trust. But here's the thing. If I complete the 30-day challenge, I don't think that's going to build any more trust in anybody's, like, any more trust in my word more than what I'm doing right now. You know, right now I'm being very honest. I'm opening up and explaining how I'm feeling about the situation, which I think, you know, might, like, hopefully holds more value than me just bullshitting my way through 30 days with low effort shit. And, you know, because that doesn't really mean anything. You know what I mean? So I did risk and reward in my head, and the reward of me completing in 30 days just doesn't really, like, there is no reward. Like, some people will be like, give me a high five, like, congrats, dude, you did it, and, like, I'll feel good about myself. But then I'll look back at the last, like, 10 days and be like, wow, I'm not happy with how some of these streams probably went.
Ice Poseidon. Think about Elixir. That kid really looks up to you. Don't disappoint him. He is following your steps, and I'm sure he will make it big one day. Don't let him down. He is a great editor, too. Paul, take care of yourself. You don't owe anyone anything.
I mean, you're right. I don't owe anybody anything, but I do like to, you know, I like to owe people stuff anyways.
You can literally just sit there and play video games for 3 hours a day. We just want to see you. You don't need to be extravagant. This is literally the dumbest shit I've ever heard. Victim Andy back at it again.
Thank you so much, dude. I appreciate that.
Why did you challenge yourself in the first place? I thought you were gonna get back into desktop streaming. What do you even do when you take days off? Feelings aren't real. They're hallucinations.
I mean, to me, feelings aren't real. You're actually right about that one. I don't really feel much most of the time, at least towards other people and the things around me. The only feelings that are real are the ones that I feel for myself, which sucks, and I hate that, and it's not on purpose, but it's just, I can't help it. Now, fuck, I lost my train of thought again. I don't know. I'm just like, I can't even think, dude. But what the fuck was, what I even forgot what you just said. Oh yeah, why did I set the challenge in the first place? I like to set myself up for challenges because it's fun. But I even said at the beginning that, well, I said at the beginning that I was going to do it and I was going to complete it, but you know, it is a challenge, and a challenge is not set in stone, so there was a high chance that I didn't complete the challenge. And I even said I would be surprised if I completed the challenge, because I just know, you know, how I am. But I still think it's fun to attempt challenges. I think it's really, really, I think it's good for me. And, you know, because I pushed myself to the point of streaming for 15 days! 15! And that's, like, that's unheard of for me. So I've already accomplished a lot in my own eyes.
The real Mr. Beast was here.
Thank you, dude. I don't know where the fuck's my 10K at, but no, I'm just kidding. But thank you, dude.
You might care a lot about your fans, but they do not care about you, Paul. They just want you to be a content machine to make their miserable lives less miserable. Your viewers are a break. Working 7 days a week is hard for anyone to do. Wake up, chat, stop being babies. There's plenty of other things you can do tomorrow when ICE takes this break. Feels weird, man.
Oh, somebody was like, what do I do in my off days? What I do in my off days is not have to worry about going live that day. And that doesn't seem like a lot. That doesn't seem like a lot of pressure. But you know what? For me, it is. And for me, it's exhausting. And having a day where I know I'm not going to go live is just pure ecstasy. Because I get to just fully enjoy myself without having to worry about anything else. Whereas if I'm going live later that day, I'm having to worry about what I'm going to do, you know, how it's going to go, etc.
Paul, this community take you for granted sometimes. They forget that you are the only streamer on Earth to get your viewers involved in anything you do. CX and chat.
Thank you, dude.
Okay, so now we know the investor doesn't exist. No one in their right mind would invest big money on a lazy quitter like you. Hire some useful people like Jacob and get rid of the cancer like Vold and SSJ.
The investor is real. We went to go look at some houses today. You guys saw it on Reddit, probably the house leak. One of the houses that were leaked. You know, they're investing for other reasons other than my work ethic, but, you know, that's another thing. You say SSJ and Vold are cancer in my life, but I disagree with that one. I think Vold just adds a good guy in my life, and I think SSJ really helps me a lot as well. I mean, SSJ, he talks with me. When I need someone to talk to, he talks with me, man. And he doesn't really, you know, he talks with me without a camera and without a, you know, something, you know, in return that he needs. And most people, you know, will talk to me without any sort of return. But at the same time, the way I met a lot of people just makes me not want to express myself emotionally to them because I don't exactly trust everybody with my full emotions.
Why are you idiots not understanding where Hess coming from? Literally, mental health is so fucking important. Stop being inconsiderate. If he doesn't fix his mental health, it'll be harder for him to stream.
This is going to be something that's really hard for people to understand. Streaming is a job that is surrounded by mental health. Streaming is a job that depends on your mental health. Like I said, I've never been like a doctor or like the president or something like of that nature, so I'm not comparing it to anything. And people shouldn't really compare streaming to, you know, other jobs as well, because that's not what I'm trying to do. I'm just trying to say and express that streaming is a job that includes mental health, which makes it exhausting in other ways that's not labor-filled.
Hey man, I'm really proud of you. I can't even imagine what you're going through. I have to work 65, 70 hours a week. I can't imagine working 22 a week. Life's hard, man. Dislike squad.
I mean, it has less to do with the amount of hours you work and a lot of other stuff.
What world are you living in? It's called work for a reason. It's not always going to be fun and easy. A man does what he says he's going to do. You have no work ethic and couldn't keep a real job.
I mean, when I was growing up, when I was in college, I had an internship, and I was a line cook. I have pretty good work ethic, but this is just a very unique kind of job, and it makes sense that people don't really understand where I'm coming from. Unless you've also been a streamer or a YouTuber or anything like that. It's very, very hard to relate. And this is why I don't like to express myself, because, you know, the majority of people won't understand. But I'm trying to, you know, express myself in a way where people might be able to understand. It's a very unique job, and it has its unique challenges and obstacles you have to overcome.
It's rather simple, no? Stop thinking and just be you.
And, you know, this guy said that it's not supposed to be fun sometimes, but that's the thing with streaming or being a YouTuber. It has to be fun all the time for you to put your entire self into it. You know what I mean? Because if I'm not having fun, you're not going to see my true self. You're going to see something that's fake. And that's not what I'm trying to convey, because that's going to give a very bad impression. You know, if I go live and I'm pretending to have a good time, you guys aren't stupid. You can see through it. And it looks very fake. And it looks very weird. And people are going to be like, what is going on with you? Fucking, like, what is happening with you? And, you know, I'm not going to want to explain it, because obviously it just sounds weird. But that's like how it is. Like, it has to be fun. Otherwise, you're going to see a fake version of myself, which is something I'm not trying to convey.
Paul, there is people out there that would die to be in your position. If you can't do 30 days of streaming, how would you work in the real world? You wouldn't have nothing if it wasn't for your fans.
You're right. I would have nothing if it wasn't for my fans. I would be in a completely different line of work. But let me tell you another thing about streaming that makes this very unique. I would also have a lot more in different cases if I didn't have any fans either. A lot of people that come in my life don't want to be in my life anymore, because they don't like my this sort of like world that I live in. A lot of people don't like being attacked. A lot of people don't like being harassed. A lot of people don't like having people judge their every movement. And that's the world that I live in. And a lot of the good people in my life don't like to come around, because they don't want to, you know, be judged by all the by my world. So, you know, it has its own unique things and challenges that you know, make things more exhausting than it looks.
It should feel like a job if your career is based on live streaming. Like an actor, show up and entertain. Be grateful you're not working a 9-to-5.
I'm very grateful I'm not working a 9-to-5. But I can't really entertain if I'm not in the right mindset at the same time.
This is the first stream I have watched. I usually watch your recorded streams. Chat is just a bunch of racists. Don't let them get you down, CX. Purple Heart. EBZ is being deported back to Africa. He needs your support.
Okay. There's no way that's happening, but thank you, dude. So Harvey exposed Streamer House on blank, and there were like 5 posts about it. They were removed. I got banned for questioning if it's real, so I'm assuming it is. Well, no, that's not going to be the Streamer House, since everybody knows where it is
already. 15 days of donation baiting is better than this desktop handy shite.
Okay. Paul, I'm an old fag, but you're feeling like this because you need to get away from LA. You even get weird when confronted that this is the problem. What happened to moving to another country? Stop the BS. It's not LA, man. LA has a high concentration of people that aren't good for me. You're 100% right about that. But anywhere I go, the small amounts of people that aren't going to be good for me are still going to congregate around me, because they're going to be the ones who target me anyways. So, it doesn't matter where I move, there's always going to be people that make it seem like it's LA anyways.
Do the arm thing.
I'm not really sure what you're talking about. But thank you, dude. I appreciate that.
Please explain the subjective side of Asperger's. How does it affect you day to day? What specific social skills do you lack? Is your arm thing related to Asperger's? What arm thing?
So I was diagnosed with Asperger's when I was like I don't even know, like 12 or something, or 14, or it's young, it's just really young. And I can talk with people. I don't have any social anxiety. And honestly, I think Asperger's might make me do things in public that would be quote-unquote embarrassing a lot more. Because when I look at people, when I look at the things around me, it's almost like they're not real. Humans communicate with emotions and body language and like all this other stuff that's more than just words and like, you know, handshakes. And that's like very face value shit. But I don't really understand emotions at all. Like I don't feel emotions from anyone else. I only feel my own emotions. So it feels like people around me aren't really there sometimes. And it's kind of just, it's weird, you know, it's a weird feeling. And it's something I've always tried to work on, but I just can't. I just don't. It's hard to work on something that I don't comprehend. And that may sound fucking weird, but I really don't understand, you know, how to communicate with emotions. Like, I'll cry and, like, shit like that. And I understand, but that's because I understand my emotions. But I don't understand other people around me more than just the face value shit. And that's just because I've artificially learned how to be more social. Just through observations and, you know, just living and just, you know, through time. But I can't really learn the emotional side of it because you don't see that. That's something you feel, and I just don't feel it. So that's how it affects me. And, you know, that does hurt my friendships a lot because I don't think I can be a very good friend sometimes. But that's not something that I purposely try to do. It just sort of happens. You know what I mean? It's if somebody's having like a rough time, or like if I'm doing something that like affects other people negatively, I don't really understand that. Like I don't really get it. I don't really like talking about this on stream because it sounds stupid and it sounds like I'm just bullshitting. But, you know, it's just how I feel.
I said dead ass truth is you have a lot of miserable people who watch you and that's their joy in the day. So they act like assholes when you don't gotta take care of yourself first, purple heart.
Thank you, dude. But that's also why I can do, you know, a lot, you know, this embarrassing shit in public. Like, I don't care what people think about me in public, because I already don't really feel what they're feeling anyways. I don't feel the resentment that other people have towards me. I don't feel that, you know, being awkward, being embarrassing is something that comes from inside of you. So if I don't feel the awkwardness because I'm not feeling the resentment from everyone else around me, that just means I can just do whatever and act stupid around people and not care, you know what I mean? Not be, like, embarrassed by some stuff that I do. So, you know, having Asperger's is actually a good thing at the same time as it being a bad thing.
How about you just stop making promises you can keep? Thanks.
I mean, I challenged myself. That's definitely healthy to do. It wasn't really a promise. It was more like a challenge.
Maybe you would be happier working an actual job. Here's $5. I spent half an hour moving heavy-ass furniture for this dono lol.
No, I would not be happier working an actual job. I'm very happy working as a streamer, 100%. But there is definitely, like, streaming is not all peachy clean. I'm very happy in the position that I'm in. I'm very thankful, and I very much thank every single one of you for supporting the stream by watching it. But, you know, streaming still has its cons and downsides as to any job. You know, being a YouTuber, being a streamer is not 100% positivity and great shit all the time.
You will regret going back on your word. What's more important? Letting down your community or letting down yourself? If you quit now, you're doing both. Sleep on it. Don't let 2019 start off with an L.
Well, if I quit the challenge, or, well, if I complete the challenge, I'm already letting down myself anyways, because I just know I can't stream up to the standard that would be acceptable for me. So I'm already going to let myself down, regardless, after 30 days. And then I'm going to probably let my community down as well if the streams aren't that great either. So either way, I'm letting both of those things down, I'm pretty sure. Whereas if I cut it, then I can just have better streams and not let myself down while also not letting my community down at the same time.
Ice, the reward is you did it. You completed the challenge you gave yourself. Giving up just shows how weak you are.
I like to think I'm a pretty strong person. This is going to be something that might really, really annoy people. I don't know, but I'm just going to say it. You have to be a strong person to be in the public eye and take criticisms nonstop. You have to. You have to. There's no way a weak-minded person could be in this position right now because they wouldn't be able to take it. I have talked to a lot of people in my life that do not want to be my friend, that do not want to have anything to do with me because they don't want to be criticized in the world that I live in. So I like to think that I'm a pretty strong-minded person.
It's not so much that you're not streaming for 30 days. What bothers us is that you give us false promises and you don't update us even though you're on your phone. Be more real and honest. It's not hard. I'm a creative pro too. Sometimes the reward isn't seen until you're done. It's hard to see on the moment. The risk for burnout is there, but you always come back. It's what makes you Ice. Experiment. It sucks that your chat are a bunch of fake supporters. Been watching your recordings, this is the first stream I've actually been in. Hang in there, man, your content is great. Your community is toxic. Think of it this way, Paul.
Thank you, man.
If you quit now, how will you feel afterwards versus how will you feel if you completed your goal? Either stay strong or accept the aftermath. Still love you either way.
This is what my perspective is. Whether I complete it or not, there's going to be an aftermath anyways. If I complete the 30 days, people are going to say the streams just weren't up to their standards. If I don't complete the 30 days, people are going to say that I quit. Either way, there's going to be an aftermath, and either way, I may see the reward, but I don't think anybody else is going to care. And that's, you know, goes back to the validation thing. If I am not feeling validated in what I'm doing, that's, I don't feel that reward that I should feel, because I don't, like, I just can't. You know what I mean?
God help you in the real world. Working a normal job, you would be sacked from the job. You're saying, what's the reward from the 30 days at work? It's money like everyone else has to work for in the world.
There's more to this world than money, my friend. And let me tell you, money does not make you happy. The money is not... I'm not depressed. But money does not make you fucking happy. Money is a band-aid that temporarily makes you feel better. And, you know, being able to feel comfortable, you know, and pay your bills and stuff, that's great. But it does not make you happy. You start to get used to stuff after a while. Okay? You start to get used to having money, or you start to get used to being able to pay your bills, and it becomes the normal, and it doesn't make you happy anymore. When I first started streaming and I first started getting some money, I was like, dang, this is really, really cool. And then 6 months later, you completely disregard the money thing, because it doesn't matter at that point, because it doesn't affect you in any way at all whatsoever. Like, money really doesn't buy happiness, dude. At all. Success could buy you happiness if that's what you're looking for. But the actual money, the superficial part, the money does not.
Paul, you need to understand you can't make everyone happy. Do what's best for you, and if people don't like it, then don't watch. That's it. Everyone wins. Do a straw poll. Do people want everyday low-effort streams, or fewer but higher quality streams?
I mean, I could do a straw poll, but I'd rather just go with, I want to make sure I'm streaming that's, you know, stuff that's up to my standard. And, you know, if something's not up to my standard, I just, I just don't even want to. I just don't even want to do it.
3 hours a damn day. Really, Paul? You're entitled little bitch. Go out and go stream now. Get desktop Andy. I work 8 hours a day washing dishes and you can't even go out. Big baby love you, Paul.
Alright, so that's something I can actually relate to. My friend. I was a line cook. And one day, my dishwasher fucking left. He just quit. He was just like, I don't want to do this anymore. He just walked out. So now I'm cooking the food and I'm washing the dishes while I'm cooking the food at the same time. Put shit on the stove. I run over to do some fucking dishes. I put that fucking clean dish on the table and then put that food on the dish I just cleaned, vice versa. That was a hard day. And we were in the weeds heavily. And that was really, really awful because there was me and one other guy cooking. But let me tell you, that was still a lot easier than what I do, you know, during this 30-day challenge, for sure. Believe it or not, I know it's hard to believe, but it was a lot easier.
Remember how disappointed you were and everyone else watching was in EBZ when he quit his challenge? He fucked up his chance at having EBZCon and now you're doing the same thing. Screwing your viewers.
Yeah, but at the same time, dude, I can't screw myself.
Don't be so hard on yourself. If you completed the challenge or not, your fans will still watch you not for the content, but because we enjoy your company.
Please
keep going, Paul. You can do it. Stream for 3 hours in the morning tomorrow, then take the day off. If you need to take a day off, then do it, but you have already done so well. We will miss you. Go cry in the closet somewhere. 15 days isn't a long time. Maybe you should just stop setting goals for the stream because you won't do it anyways.
That's what I don't understand. This guy says to stop setting goals for the stream because I won't do it anyways. But if I didn't try to set this goal, I wouldn't have streamed 15 days in a row, which is something that I've never done before. So I'm actually really happy I set this goal for myself because we streamed for 15 days in a row. So I don't really understand why you would say that when we've already accomplished something that I've already never done before.
Your mental health and happiness are more important than anything else. You cannot make others happy without making yourself happy and taking care of yourself first.
That's a good point.
Our community consists of three fans. The ones that just want autistic Florida guys playing RuneScape. Ones that want nothing but Earl streams even if they are forced. And then fans that just want consistency.
And support, it's hard to please all three.
He is original creative content. Dude, you work only 3 hours a day. Come on, man, you're lazy.
I think it has less to do with laziness.
I think you overanalyze and overthink things. I was never a big fan of Sam, but I think you two should do occasional streams together. Fuck the haters. No one cares, you baby. Figure it out. Your streams have been trashed for months. Look at all these pay pigs sucking up to you. Go get beat by Brandon again, you coward. Why, I feel sad. Shut up.
My friend. I'm so sorry that your life is probably not very good, but I'm here if you need somebody to talk to.
Okay, if you feel like you want to quit, then stop. But AD, at least give us another 2 to 3 days before attends. Don't just come on and be like, okay, it's over, and end at 50%. The point of a challenge is to persevere through your feelings. Laziness, resentment, worry. These are just in your head. Make yourself hard and tough-minded. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger.
Yeah, but I don't want it to negatively affect my YouTube channel and negatively affect my streams as well. If I have 15 streams where I'm resenting the streaming, that's not good. And that's going to affect the streams negatively. And I don't want that to happen because that's going to affect the channel negatively. It has, like, it's not just about me. It's about the channel as well. And it's about the sort of thing that I'm, like, portraying while I'm on camera. And, you know, the feelings of resentment, if I have those feelings for, let's say, 10 days in a row, people are going to think those feelings are going farther than they really do. even when the challenge is over and I don't feel that resentment anymore. Because people like to hold on to stuff.
I completely get why you are quitting and agree with all you're saying. Quality is better than quantity. What pisses me off, however, is how you don't do the simple things like updating us or streaming on time. The internet is, unfortunately, a figurative tumor on the brain for content creators. IRL streaming has to be mentally draining because of how much of your own life is being treated like a commodity.
That's true. But my life is, not my life. My life is... your life. And what was the one before that? Let me see. Hold on. Yeah, I need to update better. I don't update good enough. I understand that. I will work on that.
Bro, you literally started the 30-day challenge because before then you were not streaming consistently and always late, so saying if you don't stop it'll affect the streams is ironic since they already there. Yo, Ice, I've been watching you since old school. Great content, bro, all the best for you and the network.
But I wasn't feeling the resentment, though. Even if it was inconsistent, I wasn't feeling the resentment, which is the main thing.
You Twitter halfway there. You will feel fulfillment. Regardless of the effort in these streams, you're sticking to your word and keeping fans happy, then take a week off and come back strong.
Got banned from Twitch for restreaming your vlogs on the platform. Keep doing what you're doing. Thank you, dude.
Listen here, bud. Who the fuck that asshole that voting on Reddit? Fix that shit now or explain it.
What are you talking about? What do you mean? Should be able to upvote just fine.
Let me be the white knight and say that after streaming so much and dealing with so much harassment, I think you deserve a break. Do what's right for you, my man. Guys, he needs to be in a good headspace for good content. He's not going to be able to put out good content if he is streaming every day. Light Squad. Paul.
Hold on.
Your community are I have some news about your chicken. Jobs. Don't worry about them, bro.
It's gone.
Haters gonna hate.
But you can get it back for $100.
Who the fuck are you?
Okay, that's not the plan. SSJ told me to say that. I thought it was,
Where the fuck is my chicken, dude?
It's not in the back, I can tell you that much. But I don't know where it is. But, you're asking who I am. I'm a real-life superhero here to cheer you up, Paul Nino.
Oh, yeah?
So,
well, I'm not exactly in a bad mood, but, what is it? How are you gonna do that?
Well, I thought we could talk a little bit, or I could tell you some cool stories. I don't have a chicken for you, though, and I really don't know where it is, because it's not in the back. So...
Okay, so...
So that's not great news.
So let's hear it, then.
What do you want to hear?
I don't know. You're the one who came here to cheer me up, right?
Yes, yes. So do you want to talk?
Or... I mean, might as well. You're already in my room, Mr. Fucking superhero.
Excuse me. Well, do you mind if I have a seat? I've been standing a lot. You see, it's been a long night in Los Angeles here, protecting the streets.
Yeah, sure. Take a seat on the couch, bro.
Okay, thank you very much. I appreciate that. So what's going on, Mr. Nino?
Not much, bro. I'm just feeling, you know, a certain kind of way.
Have you ever gone out and patrolled crime? I know there was one time you went to Skid Row and actually built a house. You
I
see,
did.
That was one of my favorite streams that you've done. Because it made me feel so good that these people who needed help got the help that they needed. And that was because of you and some of your friends. Unfortunately, that was the only stream you did building a house in Skid Row. But I was hoping for more of those. Is there a chance in the future?
I mean, maybe. We didn't help anybody. I'm pretty sure the city of LA trashed it the next day.
But you're not sure?
Like, I'm pretty sure.
Well, it was there for a night. A night that somebody could have got mugged. It's all about getting yourself out there and at least helping out a little bit. There's some nights I'm patrolling the streets and nothing happens. It's very boring. Nothing at all. Sometimes that could go on for a week or a month or 6 months. But eventually you do find that one person that you help out and it succeeds. And it's in that moment. It's in that moment that you truly feel alive. And that stream made me feel alive, Paul Nino.
Well, that's awesome.
Thank Thank you.
That's really cool. Thank you for that. That's really cool. I mean, I'm glad that you really like that one.
Yes.
I do my best to try to help people. I help people through streaming. You know, when people who watch the stream, viewers, they seem to like the stream as well.
They certainly do. They certainly do.
So, I mean, I guess that helps them, and that, you know, people are helped every day.
Exactly. So that's a good way of looking at it too. You do help.
But that doesn't really make me feel that much better.
About what?
About just, I don't know, how I feel at the moment.
Do you think you might feel bad because your schedule has actually been kind of messed up? Not streaming, but just in terms of sleeping and general stuff like that. Little things like that can really screw with your mind.
No, I mean, most of my sleeping schedule has only been bad this week.
Only this week.
Because I've been having, like, just really degrading thoughts.
But this week has been, this has been the bad week, though, right? I mean, before that, it was okay.
I mean, before my sleeping schedule was messed up, I still had those degrading thoughts.
I see. Well, that is troublesome.
It's very troublesome.
So what can we do about that, I wonder?
Not burn myself out.
I would actually agree with that.
I mean, I think that's the best
thing
to do.
Might be the unpopular opinion, but personally, I do think that's more important. Not burning yourself out and getting it back 100% the next day, or if it's not 100%, at least you'll be a little better.
Yeah, I mean, that's what I'm thinking too, man. Like, honestly, but, I mean, who are you?
Who am I? My name is Hei, H-E-I.
H-E-I.
H-E-I, yes. I'm a hero for fun.
Okay.
Oh, also, you were talking on the way here about emotions. I think I do know a good solution for you to connect more with people and to understand emotions a little better.
How?
I think you need to watch more anime, sir.
No, because the emotions on anime are all fake.
Well, okay, it's actually a fair point considering it's animation, but it's based off real events or, you know, inspired by true things and things like that. I think anime can truly help you out. I really do. I know you haven't seen the finale of Dragon Ball Super yet, and it's been over a year and a half. Since you were stuck on about episodes.
I've watched a lot of anime, and the only thing I got out of it was wearing colored contacts and looking gay.
Looking gay. You have not watched enough My Hero Academia. I like that one. You might have guessed.
I mean, I literally wore colored contacts, but I mean, I don't think anime is going to help me understand emotions any better, dude.
Well, you could try it out. What do you have to lose?
I used to watch a lot of anime.
And how did you feel back then?
The same.
Well, you've changed. It's been a long time. You said you used to watch a lot of anime, so maybe you'd have a different perspective now. I actually, myself, was almost getting out of it. Also, I think we have the same pepper gel. Is that the one that didn't work? I hope it's not.
No, it's you have that one too?
I do, yeah. It's actually right here. Same one, right?
Why does a superhero need pepper spray?
Because every now and then, you know, you might have someone pull a knife or something, and I can't carry anything illegal. And I actually can defend myself pretty well, but if someone had a knife, I'd rather them be somewhat blind if I had to deal with that. Okay. And I would rather run away, too, than try to deal with it, you know? So.
Is that you, Jacob?
No.
Okay. So,
we actually have met before. It's been a little while.
Oh, you're the guy with the trench coat.
Why would you think that?
I mean, am I wrong?
You are not wrong. No.
Okay.
But I'm surprised you remembered, considering that was almost a year ago on your first hide and seek stream.
I remember a lot of things, dude. I remember a lot of people I meet.
Yes, but I mean, I also wasn't wearing a mask and makeup at the moment, so I'm also surprised about that. I'm also talking with a very manly voice that I did not have before, so I'm impressed.
Yeah, but I don't need to know your face. You when you wore the trench coat, you talked about anime. You brought your anime, like, shit that you collected. And
no, you're right. Right.
Or like that might have or like some trading cards or something.
No. I brought a wheel for your hamster. Or
yeah.
Pepper.
So it's like
not a hamster.
You know, it just makes sense that it was you.
See, you're very deductive. That's good. That's good. That was quick. That's the kind of talent that a hero needs. Good detective skills.
So what are you doing here?
Well, I was in the area, like I said, and I had planned on coming today. I wasn't sure if it was the best time after seeing how the stream's going, but I figured it wouldn't hurt. So I came on by after a patrol, and I saw SSJ in the driveway. And you told me to say the chicken thing, and now I'm here. But really, your chicken's not in the back, I don't think. Unless you,
No, it must be in the back, but he's in the driveway, dude. Okay.
Yes.
So, now that you're here, what's your purpose?
What's my purpose? Well, I wanted to chat, and originally I did want to talk about some, ideas I had for streaming as well. But...
Okay.
But yes, I'm here.
What are some ideas?
Yes, so... I think that the IRL streaming community needs more positivity in it. I think there needs to be more people like me that will go out and fight crime live on camera. I think that could be the next big thing.
I mean, you're right, but my friend, that's illegal.
It's not. Depending on how you handle the situation.
Well, when you
we
say...
We cannot do anything illegal.
Okay, if there's a drug deal going on Hollywood Boulevard, what do you do?
Well, if there's nobody in dire need of assistance, we would just call the police.
Okay, what if there's somebody getting beat up by a gang of hooligans?
Yes, at that point, what we do is we run in full speed with the pepper spray out, and we just spray all around, and...
But that's illegal. That's assault.
I mean...
The law doesn't care who you're helping.
That is most certainly not assault.
That is assault with a weapon.
It might be battery.
That is battery.
It might be battery.
Actually, I think assault's worse than battery. That's assault with a weapon.
Assault is worse than battery, yes. But this might be battery, if anything.
In fact, that's 4 cases of assault. It's probably like 5 years in jail.
Well, there's a reason we wear a mask and hide our identity, so nobody can tell who we truly are. Unless...
If the police pulled up on you, they would open fire, because you have a mask
on. People have told me that, but I disagree. That's why I had the cape. Which, by the way, is not the best setup at the moment. If you can see here, we've got little pins.
I see that.
Yes, I need to work on that. But originally, I did not have the cape, and I agreed. I thought that actually was probably not the best look.
You look like a bank robber.
So we added the cape, and I don't think I look like a robber anymore with the cape on. I think it's very obvious that I'm a hero.
I mean, it is obvious with the cape. You're right.
Little kids. I've had little kids have their parents drive by. Just so they can ask who I am and what superhero I am and what have I done, you know, things like that. Uh-huh. Before I had the cape on, it wasn't like that. They would go the other way. It was very sad. So I'm not trying to scare anybody.
So what kind of superhero are you?
I am still a novice superhero, to be quite honest. I'm very humble. I have a lot to learn, but I'm leveling up quickly. I look at it like experience points that are gained.
Are you a level 50 crook?
I am really a level 10 hero. That's pretty much where I decided I was at last time.
Okay, so what are some other ideas you had? Because if we took a fucking stream and we go out and we try to look for crime, we're gonna get beat up, we're gonna get jumped, and we might even get stabbed, like probably.
I don't know about that. Listen, you've done a crime stream before.
And then if we go and we find the people doing a crime. Calling the police really isn't that interesting to
watch.
Listen.
I've done a lot of research into all this. This movement, there was a movement called the Real Life Superhero Movement that was actually big about 10 years ago. And a lot of those people are either now out of touch with anybody, or they quit, or, you know, things happened. But I think it's time to get that movement started once again. I really do. There are some people in San Diego already doing this, and some in New York, some in Toronto. But there's not really any in Los Angeles, surprisingly. I've reached out to a few groups, and there's none here.
They go out
and look for
crimes.
Change. Yes. Looking for crimes. Basically, the police, the LAPD, actually has a service called Citizen Patrol, where they will train you, they'll give you a walkie-talkie, they will give you an actual car as well. It says Citizen Patrol on it. So the LAPD already has systems like this. What we're doing, my group and I, we are taking that concept, but we're removing the official connection with LAPD. And we're a little bit more free range, is how we like to call it. Free range. And so we are not tied down to the same things that they are.
So where do you where would you go to find some crimes?
Well, I've been over Los Angeles and Canoga Park most recently. There was some gang violence going on.
You want to go to, what is it called?
Canoga Park?
You want to go to Canoga Park, where gang violence is prominent, and would dress like that and call the police on everybody while we're there.
You don't sound very positive about this idea.
We're going to die.
You're worried. I understand.
We're going to die. Not only do we stand out as the people who are calling the police, but when they see us calling the police, they're going to shoot us.
Okay, so that's the misconception. They will not see us. We're very covert. Like, if I didn't have the cape on, honestly, you would not see me nearly as easily. Like, not even, probably 50% reduction or so. That's why all the black, you know? All the black keeps out of the way. So, ideally, we would not have to confront anybody. We're just extra eyes and ears. So, if we see something bad, we call the local department, whether that's LAPD or the Valley Division or wherever we are. You call them, you let them know, you record it, so you have proof. And the PD handles it from there. Most scenarios, we would not get involved. Unless it was urgent, like I said. And at that point, you might be right. There might be something illegal. It might not be legal at that point. But I'm willing.
So, okay, let's say, let's say we go to this park. How do we know who's breaking the law?
We go to a park? Oh, yes, we look around. You see, what we do is we take our light. And we would, excuse me, there we go. That doesn't usually happen, I promise. But yeah, we would take our light, and we would just shine it around, and, I like to stay in my car most of the time, and just kind of patrol around. I would, shine this through the light, and just kind of, you know, see who's in the park, and if they should be there or not, and if everything's okay.
So let's say, what do you do when somebody confronts you, like, hey, motherfucker, why are you shining a flashlight on me, you piece of shit, goofy ass motherfucker?
Well, we tell him to calm down a little bit, and explain what's going on.
And then he pulls a gun.
Well, it's never happened. But it could.
Bro.
I will accept that. It's definitely possible.
You're gonna die.
Like I said, I'm only level 10. I do have experience to get. I'm not as experienced as some of these guys have been doing it for 10 years or so. But I've been doing it for a few months. 4 or 5... Actually, well, the first time I did do it was about a year ago, but I did not stay consistent. I did it a year ago and I stopped for about 6 months. Until recently. And it's been going well. It's not, it's not as dangerous as you would think, I would say, depending on the area you go.
Do you think it would be interesting to watch, though?
I do.
For us to sit in a car, shine, oh, those guys might be doing a drug deal, let's call the police. Do you know the response time for the LAPD is like 35 minutes?
It's pretty bad.
The police aren't going to catch anybody.
That's why we would have footage. I mean, depending on how bad it is, you know, we could hand them the footage from the stream or the recording. And they could have the identity through that. So that's where the true weapon comes in. The true weapon that you would have, or that I would have while doing this, is you are always going to be recording. So your true weapon is not your fighting. You can fight if you need to.
But unless we're getting close up, to them, we're not going to see their faces. And if we get close up with a camera, they're gonna fucking kill us.
That's true. But let's backtrack to the park thing real quick. So you mentioned being in the car, right? So if you're alone, which I tend to do these things alone, then I will mostly stay in the car, yes. But if you have at least one other person or a few people with you, then it's better to go on foot. And at that point, you can get closer. At that point, you don't have to be as careful. For example, when I'm doing it in the car, I also combine this, I didn't mention, with the crime streaming, right? So you could have a scanner going off in the car. That is totally up to you. Do you prefer going around looking for crime, or do you prefer actually doing like a stringing thing? For me, I personally would rather go around looking for crime. The stringy thing is a side thing, right?
Looking for crime's not as easy as you think it is, though.
That's true. But, listen, there was a story from a few days ago, right? This lady was at a bus stop. And at the bus stop, she got raped. And nobody was around to help her. This was in the middle of the night, but it was at a bus stop, which tends to have lighting around it. Nobody helped until the bus arrived. And at that point, the man left. So what does that story tell you?
I don't know.
It tells you that sometimes there just needs to be more eyes and ears on the street, and that's what we're doing. We are being more eyes and ears for the police. Because
what I think is going to happen if we stream this is that we're going to sit around for like 2 hours, not find any crime, and then call it a day. Or if we find crime, it's going to take hours to find something that's going on. just for us to call the police, not get involved, and then them not get caught anyways.
So let me ask you a question. Where could we set you up with an outfit? Like, what would you... Do you have any idea in your mind, like, what would you want? Because between you and me, this mask is not ideal. But, you know, things can be adjusted here and there. But where would you start exactly? And then we can think about where to go from there. Like, do you think you would like a cape or not? Let's start with that. That's always, when you're talking about real life superheroes, the first question is always, would you like a cape?
I mean, I would need a cape.
You would need a cape. I agree. There's that movie that came out. What's it called? The Incredibles, right? Everybody hates capes because of that movie, but...
No, capes are great, dude.
Capes are great. I'm glad you agree.
They differentiate you from the rest.
Yes, you do need a cape. Not having a cape is ridiculous. That's totally fantasy in the movie. Real life superheroes have capes.
I have a cape.
You have a cape already.
I have a king cape.
A king cape? Oh, yes. Yes, the one you wore with the chair and all that. Look at this. This is a good start. And it's very unique, too. Yeah, look at that. It might be a little big. But
that's the point of a cape, though, right?
Yeah, and you know, I think we could work with this. I really do. As long as it doesn't drag. Yes.
So I don't think this is a very ideal cape. I will get.
It might be a lie.
I'm pretty sure I will get jumped by some gangster who thinks I have money wearing this.
I would agree with that one. Listen, I disagree with some of the points you've made tonight, but I do agree that cape's not ideal. But at least you have one. It's just a little. It's a little eccentric. It's a little long.
So if I wore this, how do you pick a superhero outfit?
Well, for example, this one I just kind of made over time with collections I had for things that I was collecting.
So what would you suggest that I wear? I have a Black Panther bathing suit.
What do you mean? What do you mean? What is that?
Black Panther?
I know. I mean, a Black Panther bathing suit. Is it like a full body, or is it like a?
No, it's shorts, bro.
Oh, okay. Yeah,
it's shorts that has a Black Panther logo on it, dude.
So I would not recommend wearing shorts alone, especially when it's cold at night. Probably not the best thing. But have you ever considered wearing those over pants?
I have an idea.
Yeah. I think we're onto something. Oh my goodness.
I could be...
We could call you
Virtual
something.
Reality Man.
I like that. I was thinking Techno Head, but Virtual Reality Man is also pretty good.
I would just need a camera so I can see.
Can you not see out of that?
No.
Ah, so you can't see that.
I can't see anything. It's black.
Okay, that is a little dangerous, but...
What do you suggest I... Don't worry, I have four. What do you suggest that I do?
What
do you suggest that I would wear then?
Let's see. If only you could see out of those, that would make a very cool headpiece. So you would have to watch your own stream, basically.
Basically.
And you would be having a delay, a slight delay. That seems a little dangerous, though.
They can call me Delay Man. I mean, give me some ideas. You're the professional here.
Okay, let's see.
I can be Flamethrower Man.
That's true. That's legal to bring, isn't it? So we could bring that, yeah. We could bring the flamethrower, and that would be something good to keep in the car, I think, you know? You could point it out the window and turn it on if we saw a crime, and they would probably run instantly.
No, they would open fire and kill us.
Do you really think that? A flamethrower, you think they would open fire? I think they would probably be scared, no? I mean, that's also assuming that they have a whole gun. They might not.
They would kill me. But we can bring it anyways. Hold on. What would you... What else? I mean, where do I get this? I don't have, like... You have, like, a whole strap on. I need, like, some spandex or something.
You have one of these, don't you? Isn't it the harness for the thingy?
No, I don't have that anymore. Nope. I broke it. I need, like, spandex or something,
yes,
dude.
Yes, if you have something spandex...
And I need a fucking mask.
When you said you had a Black Panther... swimsuit, I was hoping it was a full, like, one body piece thing, which is a little awkward, but we could work with that from there and build it up. So, let's see. What's this?
Oh, that, I can wear that. That's a good jacket.
Yeah, this is very good. Very good.
Hold on.
It matches, too.
Let me grab something here.
good start. That's good, that's good. I was hoping that you had the harness still. That's too bad. I do have an extra, but I did not bring it.
I was hoping that I had a camera so I could actually see out of the fucking virtual reality helmet, but that's okay. Actually, I do have a Vive, and it has a camera on the front, so I could theoretically see. There's even thermal vision.
That's like some Batman stuff. I like
but
that.
I don't have, I would need to have like a giant battery with me and a laptop in my backpack and carry a bunch of wires and zip tie them.
No.
Be fucking wire man over here.
No. You don't want to do any of that. Oh my god.
But what I do have is this. But I don't think I'm a superhero at this point. I think I'm more of like the Purge.
You know, some people say my outfit's scary, so you might still be able to get away with that.
I feel like the hat gives me a little bit of more...
It keeps it a little still, right?
A little bit less scary, a little bit more silly.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And then we have...
I do have more face paint as well. If we don't use it for your face, we could...
let me see some of my face paint. I can do something with my, like, hands.
Yes.
Just like that.
We could make your hands black.
But what would I call myself?
Well, I'm not sure yet.
What would I be?
You see, there's the G.I. Joe Copperhead, I think, but that's not...
I don't want to be no damn Copperhead, homie.
No. There's got to be, We could call you Regal Wonder, because your cape is so regal. That's not bad, if I may say so.
Homie, Regal Wonder? That's not a fucking superhero name. Wait, we gotta keep the vibe similar.
Well, you have a few people watching, luckily. Maybe they have an idea for a name for you.
Chat, what would my superhero name be? That's what I want to know.
Shadow Friend. What about Shadow Fiend? That's kind of cool.
I don't want it. Shadow Friend, no.
No, not Friend. No. Regal Wonder. Yeah, we got to vote for Regal Wonder. I think it's a good name, personally. Captain CX is actually a very good name for you as well. I think that's pretty fitting. I did not come up with that, but... What do you think about
those? It's hard to breathe in this fucking thing.
Yeah, that's the problem. That's the problem about full masks. See, I would like to keep this one, but if it was more, like, rectangular.
The Golden Goblin.
That's pretty good. It reminds me of a
Golden Shekel. Oh.
Yeah, that's fitting for you.
Yeah, I like that. That's good. That, or I could just be Ice Poseidon.
You could.
That is also a superhero.
The real
name.
Question is, how much of your identity would you like to hide? Because if you go out and do this, would you want random people to know? You're like, if you tell them you're Ice Poseidon, they look it up, they'll find you. That's the only problem.
I will be.
Which
the,
is fine.
I will be the Golden Goblin then.
I kind of like that. I kind of like the Golden Goblin.
And then, I also have my fireworks. Hold on, let me...
That's a good weapon for desperation, you know? You gotta scare them away real quick.
Alright.
You're looking like a true hero. I thought.
I need something for my shirt.
Yeah, you gotta stay warm. You're gonna need some more padding. Well, you do have the jacket. That might actually be kinda cool.
Let me see that red jacket.
It's either gonna be too much
to wear
red.
A North Face jacket.
It might be too much red, or it might look like freaking perfect. I'm not sure. You need a good belt as well, my friend. I hope you have one.
I don't.
That's a shame. But we can work on that another time. A good belt's important, though. liking it.
Dude, I look like a fucking retard.
See what I mean about the matching?
I don't know if I look very superhero-y, though.
Well,
I think I look fucking stupid.
You're working with what you've got. Don't forget you also have this. This we can definitely take around. See, if you have this, it's gonna look pretty good.
Perfect. Now, where's my fucking... I don't want this. This will be a bitch to carry around.
Might be too much.
I have the fucking Febreze, and I need one more thing. Hold on.
Are you taking the Febreze over the pepper spray? I don't know if I recommend that one.
My flamethrower, dude.
Just imagine off in the night with the flamethrower dressed as a hero. That's truly living.
Just take this thing. Just take that.
That's the real deal, isn't it?
So if somebody presses us, if someone presses us and we just show them who's boss. Show them what's up.
There you go. Oh, I don't know about that.
What?
It's gonna look like a real firearm. Having it like that.
You trying to die or what?
Well, not really. I'd rather not. We can't help people if we're dead.
Nah, this is gonna pretty save our life, bro. What you mean? It's gonna help us.
It's either gonna help us or get us killed. I guess I'm open for that risk. I mean, you're not wrong. It would definitely help in some scenarios.
Yo, is the flamethrower in there? One second.
Hello?
Where's the flamethrower?
Why do you want it?
I'm gonna go out and fight crime.
You're not going to use it in the house?
Yes.
Okay. It's in the guest house.
Where?
moved everything around so he could put his bed in there. So you have to ask him. I'm sure he saw it when he was moving stuff around.
But where'd you put it at?
Like right next to where the laundry room door is, on top of just whatever was there. I didn't like hide it. I just put it on top of the stuff.
Okay, thank you. Alright, tracksuit, you motherfucker. Where the fuck is it? You better not have moved it and hidden it somewhere.
Let's hope not.
I'm gonna go grab it. Why don't you take a seat here?
Surely. Is this thing, is this thing working?
Yes.
Excellent. I think he's going to make a great hero, to be quite honest. Especially with the flamethrower. That's a nice touch. Well, I'm glad you guys are enjoying the idea. Yes, it's going to be a good one. I'm just hoping we're not biting off more than we can chew bringing a flamethrower. But sometimes a hero needs to take risks. Especially when it's already nearing midnight. We'll see. I'm no sidekick. Don't worry about that. Of course, it's always a little scary. I'm not going to lie to you. But that's why you must put on a smile. And say, I am here. And everything's okay. Look at that. When people see this, they will know a hero has arrived. And they will not be scared anymore.
They're gonna think it's the Purge. They gonna think we out here killing motherfuckers.
Well, if they are getting robbed, I'm sure that they'll be glad to have a Purge happening, no?
We're ready. I think I look really superhero-y.
You,
I think this
you
makes
add
me
something.
It makes me look more, makes me look less fucking intimidating. These goggles, dude, and it helps protect my eyes against pepper spray.
That is good.
I'll bring the spray anyways. Just like that.
Excellent.
I'm ready for it. Do I look like a superhero or do I look like a supervillain?
I think you look like a hero, personally. Do you want to know why?
What do you think, chat? Why?
Most true supervillains only have one thing that they're really good at, and they just build everything to that motif. For example, there's a man in England who goes around putting fake parking tickets on people's windows. There's also another man who calls himself Dumpster Man, who goes around littering. And his costume is themed after trash. So...
What do you mean, dude?
I'm saying since you have a mixture of things going on here, it's obvious that you are not a super villain.
I have an idea.
That's all I'm saying.
I have a bottle of kerosene. I'm going to poke a hole through the top, and I'm going to spray them with the kerosene, then get them with the flamethrower so they burn. They want to steal a fucking purse of my watch, I'll burn them.
You're getting pretty into this.
I mean, fuck it, dude. Fuck it, dude. It doesn't really matter.
Well, we probably don't want to burn them to death.
No, you want we're gonna burn them to death. We should go. I need gloves.
Yes, if you do have some, that's great. If not, I can make your hands black.
Can I see the spray? Can I see the paint?
I can get it.
Yes.
It's very simple, though. It's a little tiny. Here, I'll get it. But yeah, so it's like this big. It's very easy. If you've never seen it before, it's great. So should I? Go the way I came, or should I?
You can go this way.
Okay, it's probably a little easier. I'll be right back then.
Yeah, I need gloves. I don't want to leave fingerprints.
Yes.
I'm gonna die. We're gonna fucking die, aren't we? Fuck it, dude. This could be fun. This could be real, real fun, dude. This goes against everything we were just talking about earlier, but... Let me, dude, we're scamming so many donos. I'm sorry. Let me let them play out. Just let me, I'm just gonna let the donos play out from like
y'all
20 minutes ago.
Y'all are just jealous that Ice has a job that earns more and have more support than all of you who would. It's very hard mentally to feel it as a streamer too. I've burned myself out and don't stream. Hi, Paul. It's Eddie here. Yes, that guy. You clicked out of your heads. Now you're quitting the challenge. The boy is no good. It's okay, Paul. Don't worry. I am offering you a new line cook job. Offer stands. Nay. Do you think maybe you are depressed and down because you literally fell in love with Burger the Planet's sloppy seconds? The alien might have been awful, but at least she didn't fuck Burger Low. As much as I talk shit and make fun of you, you're an artist, an entertainer. Working hours doesn't matter here. Though do wake up earlier, motherfucker. Night streams are getting old. Look at the positives. You have a beautiful girlfriend. People that admire you. You are healthy. Have a home. You know what happens to people like you? People are jealous and they attack you. But if you stay positive, they'll go away. You guys go on about how this is work. And how we made it that you guys do realize most jobs have days off right. Fuck this community, man. Ice do you, man. Either that or this is a donor they love. Paul the First understand. What works for me is apt to not overthink stream plans unless it's necessary. Or that in the end of the day is to have fun. Do whatever the fuck you want, Lowell. We love the streams. It's all good. The more you resent streaming, the more the quality of the streams is going to diminish. Take care of your mental health first. Go back to the old format if that's what helps you. The 30-day challenge will break you down and reveal your true self to us. That's why we want it. We don't need to see top-tier content. We need to see a true self, even if TS scuffed.
Bro, I wish I still had my... Good point. I wish I still had my boxing fucking training gloves.
Why don't you just get a cameraman to follow you? You could take a week and do online counseling. You should go to a sensory deprivation chamber. Go get massages.
Beautiful.
Do things that help your mental heat.
Maybe we should only do the tops.
People don't seem to understand how hard it is to be an entertainer.
Here, come back.
Being in the spotlight and expected to be entertaining all the time is extremely draining and stress-inducing. I just take a break. Here's a video of you doing the arm thing.
That's actually pretty good. I don't have any of those myself, at least.
I've got a couple of these.
Yeah, I don't have any like that.
I'm ready.
Ready,
dude. Fuck the
black hat.
I'm gonna be black
hat
over here.
Read super chats, my man. Alright, before we go, I need to wash this off, though, so I'm gonna track it all over the place. The restroom right here. Need a little water.
You need to take acidism as that sounds. It'll help with your emotional awareness temporarily that you'll be able to take into your day-to-day life. Be a man about it and admit you haven't enjoyed streaming for a while as piss. You realize you wouldn't have anything or anyone around you if it wasn't for your stream. It's the only reason you don't quit. I'm beginning to think bold and SSJ is the cancer here in the chat is. Jesus let the man do what he feels is best for him. CX and chat to the real ones.
Not a fan of the black hands?
Imagine living in 2019 and still thinking the people around you are real.
Fuck the gloves. Fuck the black hands. The black hands are... wait, there's gloves on the floor. Those are yours.
Oh, yes, those are
those are yours.
They're mine, indeed. Thank you.
Fuck it, dude.
Not sure how they fell off.
Fuck it, we're good to go. Let's just go. We're gonna go. You're gonna show me how to fight crime,
then.
I'm gonna show you a few things.
Imagine how people feel out of the mood of coke, fuel, and a steel mill when they work in 100-degree weather. Spoilers, they absolutely hate it. Sup, Ice, can I rest my junk in your forehead? Hyphonics won't let me. Also, sometimes I bust in the screen and pretend I busted all over you. Thanks.
Okay, thank you.
CX in the chat.
Oh, there's a lot of fucking shit. Okay, so the 30-day challenge continues on. I mean, I guess if it continues, fuck it, dude.
Well, an hour and a half, it'll be tomorrow.
The obsession I have for you is the only thing I have going on in my life. Just take the time you need. I have no friends and don't relate to other people.
Use socks as gloves. That's innovative.
It's the Reddit man. They are literally losers that take joy in the misery of others. They want you to be lonely so they get more of you. You are growing up. They aren't. Time to make changes, homie. This is my first time ever donating to any streamer. You are a good person, Paul. I get so much enjoyment from your streams and the content that you create.
Any idea?
You saved it, bro.
Well, I'm glad. That means even if I don't fight crime tonight successfully, at least I saved something.
Yeah, you helped me show. You helped show me that there's more than just fucking dumbasses out there.
I'm glad to hear that.
I got so many funny ideas, I'm still gonna do it, fuck it, dude. So I'm just getting the past 3 days of donations, you goblin.
Nobody yet.
I'm not sure the best area around here, though. That's the only thing. So maybe you can help me out with that.
If you didn't have to breathe to live, you would quit that, too. You are still a boy, not a man. SJC streams everyday baby boy.
We should go.
I know.
Read about this. Depersonalization derealization disorder.
What is that? Oh, I've heard of that. We need to go to,
You still got the damn chicken?
I don't know, to be honest. Where, I mean, what do you have? How do you find shit, dude?
Well, we could go to downtown. Although I don't know where we'd park. Skid Row is probably a little bit too dangerous, to be quite honest. I probably wouldn't recommend going there.
Let's go to downtown then.
We could go to downtown. There's always people there.
There's always fucking crackheads as well. We gotta, if someone's on crack, we gotta tell them not to be on crack anymore.
We can definitely do that. I think that would help them out. Drugs are bad, right? So we cannot let them, pollute themselves like that. You know, if we're there, might as well say something.
Come on, Paul. The feeling of accomplishment after 30 days will feel amazing. But I understand. Here's a challenge. Stream for the next 15 days about checking the Reddit or focusing on the chat. I have a friend in Asperger and a therapist told her to visit the ICU every day. It helped her totally. You'll probably understand.
What the fuck is the ICU?
Intensive care unit?
Well, you're smart because you have developed over time a way to dismiss the criticism or in a way make it not affect you as much as normally would be affected. Remember, this is way better than a regular job.
I know.
Streams is a challenge of its own. Quality over quantity. Take it easy to your CX. It's easy to say money isn't everything when you spend more than people's yearly salary on food alone. Your friends don't want to be around you because they aren't the ones getting paid to be criticized.
That is true.
Paul, you can learn to use to help
you. Do you have a police radio?
I have a way of accessing one.
How?
Over the phone.
It will help. Love you, bro.
You don't need an actual radio. That's nonsense.
What do you mean over the phone?
There's plenty of apps out there that let you tap into radios. You don't need an actual radio to get on the radio. That makes sense. I can show you what I mean. That might be a little easier.
If you give up on this challenge, it's fine. You do what's best for you, man.
Okay, I'm gonna have to scam these donuts. There's literally 20 minutes of donations backed up, dude.
Do what you need to do.
Okay, well, let's just go then. Let me... Oh my god, I'm so sweaty. It's nice. Thank god it's cold outside. Alright, hopefully this doesn't backfire on us, bro. Like, this could backfire on us.
I think downtown's not too dangerous.
We're tired of your shit. The rationale behind this is that you need to do what makes you happy and not what makes the community happy. You're right, it's hard to please them all. So you need to decide who you want to be here. Stop letting fans tell you how to live your life. Love you. Insert advice here. Blah, blah, blah. Blah, 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 blah. Love you, Ice. By the way.
Alright, well, let's go. You have your car up front?
I sure do.
Alright, we're gonna go in his car. And we're gonna start this. Let me go get my live view turned on. Be right back, everybody. Give me 1 second, please.
Maybe you need a short break. I've been watching you for years, and I always enjoy the streams. You're very talented.
I hope.
Don't let this get you down.
Bro, I hope this doesn't backfire. I'm really...
Before I give you an answer, let me ask you, what do you mean by backfire?
I'm really putting trust in you here. I hope we don't die.
I don't think we'll die. The only thing I'm worried about is bringing that flamethrower. That is legal, right? I don't know too much about those.
It's legal.
Then we shouldn't have problems.
Alright, I looked it up. It's 100% legal.
You need to walk around with it?
Yes.
Alright.
Yes, and toggle it.
I challenge you to use the remaining 2 weeks to make your CX members' streams better instead of your own. You won't need to stream unless you want to. Each day, different CX. Win-win. Love you, bro. Your personality is the driving force of your content. Always remember that.
There we go.
Always looked up to you, man. You're the reason why I started streaming. Good job completing your job, man.
I'm just looking for the scanner for this sector.
So while we go out,
I understand what you're complaining about. We all have normal jobs. You won't get sympathy. You're not saying you are right or wrong.
What's your super name?
You ice when the streamer
it's,
house.
Hey,
H-E-I.
Hey,
you're going to Airbnb, a separate room, and
yes,
you're going to have a blast of a
true hero for fun.
Possible.
And thank you for asking.
Yeah, no problem.
What's your name?
So hold on. This is Morris.
What's up, guys?
And he's going to be the cameraman for today. He's living with me for a couple days here. He came all the way from Florida.
Yeah.
To
try to be a streamer, like everybody else that shows up, pretty much.
Well.
And what do you think? What makes you different from the rest?
I like to do jackass content. Not like over the top, but I like to do stuff like that. But it makes my streams a little short, like an hour. So I'm trying to figure out a good balance of like 3-4 hour streams, but still doing like kind of crazy little challenges and shit like that. I don't know.
So okay.
I'm just trying to find a balance.
Well, if you can be a good camera guy, that'll be a great start. All
right.
Cool. If the camera work is not very good, then I don't know how you can be a streamer. So we'll see how you can do, bro. All right.
Jacob's alter ego from Universe B.
All right. The live view's turned on, so give it a second, guys. How do you guys think it's going to go? Hopefully not as punched in the face.
Did you hear that on the scanner? I already said that. All good. That's a good sign.
Stop drinking. Get in the gym. Get around people who support you and truly want to see the best in you. Hey, what's up? It's 12 a.m. in Houston, Arden. I gotta wake up at 6 a.m.
Did you see that movie? The superhero movie?
I've seen all of them. Every single one. No, I'm just kidding.
No, the one on Netflix about the real life superhero. That one was dope.
Oh, yes. Exactly. As I was telling him 10 years ago or so, the movement was actually much bigger than it is today.
Yeah.
So I'm hoping to reinvigorate it with a newfound life.
That would be dope with live streaming.
Exactly.
Everyone, spin. Spamming tryhards. Can we get some tryhards in the chat, bros?
Pickup sticks. You hear that?
Oh, shit. That's actual standing?
Yep. I'm trying to find the right location for downtown. This is... I know this one. Oh my god. That song.
Where the fuck is my camera? Where's my camera?
I know which. Look.
Stand and deliver.
You want to use my GoPro?
What song
no,
was
no,
that?
I have my camera, so the GoPro.
What song was that? I know that song. I'm too distracted right now, though. Goblin Slayer, yes, the intro, that's right. Thank you. Thank you.
What?
That's definitely not me.
Where the fuck's my camera, dude?
Wasn't it in the front? I think I saw it.
Where?
The white one?
No.
Oh.
My
well, that's not, I did not
my
see that
black one.
One. I only saw the white one.
Where the fuck is my black camera, dude?
I'm sure Evan would be happy as fuck to stream 3 hours today.
That is very official. I like that.
No one's gonna fuck with us.
No, they won't. They definitely won't.
Thank you. Where the fuck is my shit, dude? I don't know where my camera motherfucking is.
Well, we gotta have that.
Where as Chicken Andy.
Now.
Come to Columbine. The trenchcoat mafia is taking over our school. Make Columbine great again.
Motherfucking ass, dude. Oh, I know where it is. In the bag. It's in the bag. It's in the fucking bag.
Give this to the Morris.
Guys, remember to send us your positive energy. Like Goku with the spirit bomb. That's what we need tonight. Because we don't want bad things to happen. Right?
Yeah.
Gosh, should I become a superhero called Shadow Friend?
I'm going with you.
What?
The amazing Shadow Friend. I think that'd be dope.
You guys can properly defend yourselves, and I actually can.
What do you mean? We have a flamethrower? We have a flamethrower. We have a taser. And we have pepper spray.
I'm gonna go just in case.
I wouldn't mind another body.
Come on. You think we're gonna die out here?
I do know. I mean, if you want to be honest, I do have 4 years Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu Muay Thai.
That is better than me.
Scott, do you think we're gonna die out there? I've got enough to look at this draw time.
I think we'll be okay. I really do. But it's always it's not bad to have more people with you.
I'm gonna go anyway. I'll be the driver.
Oh.
Yeah.
Well, then I definitely don't mind.
You're doing great. That thing's not even loaded, by the way.
Shh.
Just so you know.
If I load it, we'll die.
Okay. I have no jiu-jitsu training.
All right, let's go.
Muay Thai for a while.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I knew you did train. I just didn't know what.
Definitely not. Nah, that was way past my time.
Oh, jiu-jitsu?
I only started like 6, 7
years. Yeah, yeah, exactly. Yeah, the Brazilians brought it over a long time ago, but it hasn't been until recently, really. You're right. Yeah.
Most of the stuff I did was just pretty much dancing, because kung fu back.
Can we take the Hummer?
I'm coming with you, yeah.
Okay, we're gonna take the Hummer. No one's gonna fuck with us in a Hummer.
Probably not. So we got one trained fighter, a guy with a flamethrower, and an unloaded taser.
Yeah, but nobody knows it's unloaded.
Two pepper gels.
A camera guy. And, me. Cool. Okay.
What's the worst that could happen?
They asked that.
The worst thing is the police, really. I mean, we're not doing anything wrong, but.
What do you mean, dude?
Definitely illegal.
What do you mean?
We need to be sure everything we're doing is legal. And, the flamethrower you say is legal, so I don't think we'll have any problems.
If the police come, all you're supposed to say is we are trying to defuse a situation.
What if we're just
walking? If the police come, we're going to say these motherfuckers taking over the city. We're going to show them who's boss.
Dude, we're going to let crime take over our city.
Bro, you know Batman don't give no fucks about the police.
I mean, that's true, but also not true. Because of Commissioner Gordon and all that. But I do know what you mean.
Okay, hold on. Let me adjust my shit here. Harvey can come with us. He can be the Henny guy.
Is he here? That is a good superhero name. It's kind of already a thing, so.
Do you want to come fight crime with us?
Alright, we're ready. It's ready. Okay, I'm gonna switch streams. Mike, I know what you said, but motherfucker. Enough.
Can I see you live?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he's
lying.
Good evening. If the cops come, they will shoot the black guy first.
Yeah, the camera guy dies first.
Well, there's two of us, so.
Bugger, dude.
I've got to be honest, I have not done this with such an interesting group of people before, but new experiences are always good.
Okay, I'm turning this
off. In some way.
Do you train in the city?
I train in the valley. A place called Z-Force.
Oh, don't say it.
It's closed down now. It's okay. I do train somewhere else now. Right. Yeah, that's where I